It's feeding time for the Tigers, the Princeton University football Tigers, that is, as they must rebound from some adversity. Not only are the Tigers coming off a 2-8 season, but recently their head coach of 2 years, Ron Rogerson, has died. Former assistant to Rogerson at the University of Maine for 4 years, and Princeton assistant Steve Tosches now takes over as head coach. Coach, what is your team's attitude, of course, coming off the loss of Coach Rogerson?
Well, I think right now, and of course when they first reported, I made that statement that my impression is that their attitude is just what we expected. And what I mean by that is that the students here, the players here at Princeton have a very strong and very sound character. And I think them dealing with this tragedy and their maturity with it has really allowed them to handle it in a very normal fashion.
You've lost quite a few players from last year. How does that look? Do you have players to fill in at those spots?
Well, we think we do. We've got a nice blend in the program right now. And again, what I mean by that is that we've got about 27 seniors. A good majority of them will do a good amount of the playing time. But then we've got a sophomore class that was a very aggressive and emotional freshman team last year. And there are some awful good athletes in that group, and they're really pushing some of the older kids, and it's really making a very competitive atmosphere the last 2 weeks here, and we hope that that continues.
Now, last year, the offensive line was a question mark. You had a few injuries, which hurt. Mm-hmm. What are your concerns this year? Is it still the offensive line?
Well, it's not the offensive line total, because I'm pretty happy with our guards, having both seniors, Mark Seelhammer and Josh Chambers, returning. Our two tackles have junior George Sarcevich and senior Andy Yohani. All four of those guys have playing time, have starting time the last 2 years. The position that concerns me is at center right now. And we have a pretty good battle going on between three or four guys, and I don't think that will be settled until after Saturday.
Who will be your quarterback this year?
Well, that's a pretty good battle going on right now. Jason Garrett is a very talented young man. He makes things happen on the field. I think that's the best statement I can make about him. He's got the edge right now, although Brian Barron, a junior, is giving him a good run for the money.
You have some pretty good backs and ends. Do you expect to throw a little more this year? How does that look?
Well, we're going to utilize our talent. And I'll make this statement that I think our receiving core collectively is stronger than any other Ivy League schools.
The guy that will probably be throwing to this fine receiving core is Jason Garrett. Garrett is an interesting story. You see, he played for Princeton as a freshman, then transferred to the University of Columbia as a sophomore. Now, last year as a junior, he transferred back to Princeton, but had to sit out, according to the college football rules.
How is the offense coming along so far in your eyes?
It's coming along pretty well. We got a lot of good talent on the offense. Good tight ends, good outside guys, good backs, line's playing pretty well. So we've been sharp in the first couple of scrimmages, but there's still a long way to go. I think it's all right, though.
You talk about your skill positions. They sound pretty good. Will you be doing a little more passing this year, possibly?
Well, I think we have to run the ball, but you know, I think we have the people to throw the ball. We have two outside guys who can run. We got a tight end who can run, but you know, we got a great tailback. We got a great fullback. So you know, I think we got to keep it balanced to keep the defenses honest. But you know, I'd like to throw it.
You're rather new here. You've been here before as a freshman, right? Is it tough adjusting to the Princeton offense again?
Well, not really, because I was here last year working with the scout team, so I kind of was in all the meetings, ran some of the plays. We're doing some new things this year, but I've been around it all spring, so I'm kind of comfortable with it now.
The Tigers do have a fine fullback in senior Jerry Santillo, who gained 437 yards on 104 carries last season. Also back at fullback is former Immaculata standout Dennis Height.
Changed your position since you've come here from Immaculata. Tell me about that and why the change.
Well, I was at a wing back, which, you know, I need a little more speed than I had. So I started bulking up a little bit, got up around 200 pounds, and they moved me to fullback now, which is better suited to my running style, I think, and my abilities to also.
Have you adjusted to that so far?
I think I've adjusted pretty well. Camp's been going okay. Hopefully I'll make some special teams, a traveling team maybe, and get some quality PT, I hope.
So what do you think? How do your chances look for playing time?
Well, they got Jerry Santillo is a great fullback, and he's seen action for 2 years, so he'll definitely be the starter. But I feel I'd be ready to step in at any time.
What can we expect on the other side of the football? For the defensive outlook, we talked to 1987 captain Matt Wayland.
Things have changed as far as our aggressiveness to the ball. Coach DePue, our head defensive coach, has been stressing that that's going to be our most important thing, is getting all 11 guys to the ball. Been doing a lot of pursuit drills, which they entail having everybody run to the ball every play, and I think that'll help us out a lot.
What do you think you still have to work on yet? What looks a little weak?
I don't think we've seen as much adversity as we need to see, that we'll see during the season. We went against the first offense yesterday, which was good. I think that was a lot of good things happened there. We saw, it's very competitive. We've been going against guys, when we go against the scout team, sometimes it's not as challenging as we'd like it to be. But yesterday we went against the first offense. I think we got a lot accomplished.
How do you think the defense's attitude is at this point?
I think it's pretty confident. I think we're confident in what we can do, and pretty much it's just we're ready to go. We're waiting for Dartmouth.